the most interesting groups in the children's album is what I call the Saga of the Doll. There are three pieces which describe the story of the doll. So there is the new doll, the sick doll, and funeral of the doll. Or at least this was the order in Tchaikovsky's original manuscript. When the first edition came out, the order was changed, and that changed order is basically what we see in most, but not all, modern editions. In these editions, the story has a happy end. We start with the sick doll, then we bury the doll, and then after a short, decent interval, the girl gets a new doll, and so happy end. I prefer the original order. To me, the story makes a lot more sense. And in any case, not everything in life ends well, and children should know that, right? But for now, let's talk about the new doll, which may be one of the easiest pieces in the cycle, something you can almost learn by rote, but again, one that presents a number of technical and interpretive difficulties. The most important technical aspect for us to work on in the new doll is the balance between the hands. Here's how I usually hear this song after it was just assigned. Do you notice the problems? The left hand is not just way too loud, but that the second note of the two doesn't just come off the key, but lays there. So we have to work on keeping the left hand as quiet as possible and really as short as possible. The solution, as to so many pianistic problems, is to be at the surface of the key and not flop the hand up and down. Even when the hand has to move and change positions, we should make sure to touch the keys first. If you find that you have trouble keeping the second note of each two quiet, think about doing a preventative diminuendo. Rather than keeping both notes exactly the same, make the second one quieter. It works marvelously well as well. Once the left hand situation is solved, now we can think about the right hand. What's interesting about the right hand is the slurring. The first phrase is four measures long and has a long slur. We have to think of it as something of a song. Did you notice the quality of my legato? I'm not doing what you can think of as a perfect legato, where each note picks up as soon as the other one plays. Instead, I'm doing what is known as a super legato, where I hold each note just a little bit into the next note. So there is a little bit of an overlap. This way I can control exactly how long each note is. There is no possibility of using the pedal here because of the staccato in the left, correct? So the super legato makes the legato sound much warmer and much more song-like. But this only goes on for four measures, because in the next four measures, the slurring becomes quite different. We have slurs of only two notes, our traditional down-ups. You can think that perhaps our girl starts to dance a little bit with her doll, or perhaps she's getting so excited that her voice breaks as she sings. After the next eight measures, our girl gets even more excited, and now her two-note slurs are much shorter and followed by rests. It is extremely important to notice the rests between the right hand notes and to obey them. Do you notice that in order to make sure that the second note is short, I'm actually making it even shorter. This is a very good rule to think about for the future. Any note which precedes a rest should be a little bit shorter than its actual numerical value, because on the piano, the strings ring for a while after we're off the note. So if we want clean rests, we have to pick up the notes sooner than they're indicated, so that there is a real feeling of breaths in between each of the two notes. Tira, 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 tira. Our girl is very excited indeed. And now let's take a look at the very ending of the piece, where our girl skips into the sunset with her beautiful new doll. We need to create a true pianissimo here. I highly recommend using the una corda, not just slamming it down at the end, but bringing it in or bringing it down very little bit by little bit. So we have something like this. Can you do it with just your fingers alone? Yes, you can. This is written for an age group that may or may not be able to reach the pedals at all. So this is only a suggestion. I hope I've answered a lot of your questions. If you have more, please leave them in the comments. Happy practicing.